Welcome back at 9:20 on your Sunday morning in a weekend. We're just 2 weeks into the 2024 legislative session. And once again, Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds is honing in on education as her top priority. So joining us to discuss the early action is State Representative and House Minority Leader Jennifer Konfrst. Thanks for being here.
Appreciate it.
Trekking out in the cold. It is getting warmer, though, however. Okay, so top headlines, like I said, education. The governor's massive education bill. We're going to spend this segment just on area education agencies. A lot of action last week. Republican leadership says that they're working on some changes with an amendment-wise. Could you explain to our viewers, too, what AEAs do for folks in the state?
Sure. Area education agencies are located in areas across the state that serve to pool resources to provide special ed, mental health, and media specialist services to teachers. They do training for professional development for teachers. They really serve as a lifeline for, especially in rural communities, families who need extra services. They can pool their resources and use them from there. It's a really important service.
And the services that you just outlined, under this proposed bill, it would cut all services that AEAs are able to offer, except for special education. The dollars would be kicked to school districts, and they would be able to choose which AEA they wanted to go to or go into the private industry. But last week, like I said, Republican leadership working on the bill, they're going to be, it looks like, we haven't seen an amendment yet, I guess, right? So right. Let's just start there. You haven't seen an amendment.
No, you know, last week when the governor announced the AEA cuts, she did so in her condition of the state address, and next day dropped a 120-page bill. And that same day, she also posted jobs that would be created with the bill already on the Department of Education website. And we actually have three branches of government, so we're not going to post jobs for a division that doesn't yet have the authority to hire for it. So that was a little concerning for us. It seemed like it was one of those, we're going to push it through and get it done. Iowans reached out by the thousands, and they were just people saying how concerned they were about their AEAs, telling personal stories. Mm-hmm. And I think that the governor and Republican leadership also heard from Iowans, both at their caucuses and in their communities, and said, oh, okay, I think we maybe need to try to change something. We'll see what it looks like. I'm not going to be relieved until I've seen the bill.
It's just interesting. Last session, educational savings accounts, I get passed in the first 2 weeks. The governor signs it into law. It looked like we were setting up for something similar like that. Is it truly just Iowans reaching out, letting their voices be heard? Is it concern from rural House lawmakers? What do you think got them to, I guess, continue this conversation or start the conversation?
Yeah, you know, I think this is a good example of the governor getting caught playing politics. She thought she could just do the same thing again. Throw out a bill, a massive bill she wants, just tell the legislature what to do, and they would do it. Both the legislature and Iowans said, whoa, whoa, whoa. Back up a minute. And since there's no one really asking for this AEA change in any sort of big way, there was really no one behind the scenes except special interests, I guess, pushing for this bill. So there's no constituency to balance out the other side. And Iowans love their AEAs. And I really think that's a lot of it.
And I just want to emphasize here, too, so that amendment, we have not seen it yet, but the talk is that it should allow AEAs to offer all the services they currently offer school districts if a school district decides to get all those services as well. Are you guys part of the conversation at all with this legislation?
No. Democrats have a lot of ideas about what we can do, and we think that perhaps if there are changes that need to be made at the AEAs, let's approach that with a scalpel instead of a sledgehammer like the governor has done. But no, we'd love to be part of these conversations. I hope that AEAs are, and I hope that families who use the services are. I talked with a woman who reached out to me named Kate, whose daughter has cerebral palsy, and just talked about the services that the AEAs have provided her. Just a quick example. Her daughter needs a stander in school, and the AEAs are providing her with several different ones to see which one helps her learn the best. Kate said, if I had to go to a private company for this, there's no way they would have spent this long making sure my kid had what she needed. That's what Iowa kids deserve, and that's why privatizing this is not a good call.
Do you see the need to rework AEAs in the relationship with school districts and with the state as well? I also want to highlight the Department of Education would oversee AEAs of the school districts as they go out and get services from them. Do you see the need? Senator Yoke, I mean, you were very passionate this last Thursday at your weekly press conference. They talk about Republicans that the dollars doesn't match the test results. Yoakum says that hey, you can't apply that to every student. IEPs, individual education plans, are very important. Is there a need to be changing the AEAs? Do you see a need for it?
There's absolutely no doubt that we can look at any system in the state and make sure it's providing the best benefit to taxpayers. But Senator Yocum is right in the sense that kids aren't products. We can't expect the same outcome from every kid and look at this like a financial transaction. We're supposed to take care of kids. Wherever they are, we get them ready. That's why teachers are so amazing, and that's why our public education system is so great, because every kid can come there and learn. That's why we think that, look, we can look at cutting around the edges, making it more modern, making it more efficient. Let's have that conversation. We're not opposed to that. We think what we need to do needs to be a lot more targeted and a lot more reflective of what AEAs and students and families say they need.
What would you tell Iowans, last question here for you as well, that are concerned about the services that they do get from AEAs? What would you tell teachers? An amendment's being worked on. It looks like their voice was being heard. What would you tell them?
I would say don't let up, right? So we saw a press release that said the governor and Republican leadership are ready to change the bill. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. The next day, the governor issued an open letter, a little less committed to overhauling the bill. So just keep reaching out. Keep telling your stories. Remember that even if your legislator agrees with you or doesn't, telling those stories helps us to see what our constituents think.
All right. House Minority Leader Jennifer Konfrst, thanks for making the trek in this morning. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
All right. We're back with more news right after this.